I think the same thing that I encourage my students to do, which is to look at the way we make images in a way that is completely personal. So I think what really is driving me is that I have a set of special talents that I can use to speak out about something that I think is in desperate need of clarity, of healing.
Lynda is a collage artist, and as such, she knows how to take disparate images of all kinds and put them together to make something totally unique, evocative, and provocative in a way that few artists can do. That's what she's able to bring into the classroom, is in the message that nothing is wrong with seeing something in a different context by putting them together, collaging them together, and making something totally, completely, utterly different than what they started with, and bringing forth kind of a new idea out of something that was pretty ordinary to begin with.
For 20 plus years, Lynda Frese has brought to this department a high level of research and integrity. In her teaching, she focuses on the student, and she focuses on their maturation as an artist as well as a researcher.
I had been going on these retreats into deep nature sites, and it started to come together that I wanted to make a book about our relationships with nature and how humans live inside of nature or live outside of nature or in harmony with nature or in disharmony with nature. And as the work started to come together, there was the series seemed to make more sense if you could see them together. So I started thinking that it would make a great collection in a book. That was when I looked at the Atlas grant again and I thought I could do this for a book.
For many years, Lynda has been interested in putting together a book about her work. She received this Atlas grant, which is an amazing feat because it's so rare. So it was just a perfect timing. She had funding for the book. She had all these great ideas that were just beginning to come out. And so it was a serendipity of timing.
I love nature in a way that's very mysterious and deep. There's this feeling of like, whoa. It gives me material that I end up using in my artworks too.
Lynda can come in and just hug you and grab you and just make your day just by coming in and being her. And she's a little crazy sometimes, and you know, but she has such a spirit about her that she's just so attractive. People just flock to her. One of the unique things about Lynda too is she's a world citizen. She travels, she absorbs it, and then she extracts from this all of this information and brings it into her art.
I had an opportunity to go to India, and I became really interested in the way they showed the Hindu deities. When I came home, what I did is I took those gods and goddesses that I had photographed, and I started to slip them into the scenes of devastation of the hurricane. That turned into a series that I called Hindu Deities Along the Gulf Coast. I'm really honored, and I'm humbled at the same time, which is a funny combination.
I think for someone who's been engaged into the university community, for someone who's given and sacrificed, as we all do, in this type of environment, for as long as she has, I think it's an honor that's well deserved. It's something that is a pinnacle of one's career in academia. And it's a way in which the university certainly can acknowledge somebody who's really devoted themselves to this institution and endeavor.
It's fun. I wish my mom was here. I'd like to tell my mom. Yeah, she'd be proud of me.